Hello students, today our topic is cyberethics, and cyberethics is the unit number 3 of its syllabus. And in this lecture we are going to discuss intellectual property and intellectual property right. So first of all, what is intellectual property? Actually, intellectual property is created by the application of human mind, and intellectual property is a term referring to a number of distinct type of creation of the mind for which property rights are recognized in the corresponding field of laws. And the articles of intellectual property are textile, cosmetic, pharmaceuticals, machinery, books, etc. These are the articles related to intellectual properties. In short, we can say that intellectual property refers to the creation of the mind, that means inventions, literacy, artistic work, and the symbols, name, images, and the design used in commerce. And basically there are two categories of intellectual property. First one is industrial property, which include inventions, trademark, industrial designs, and second is copyright, which include literacy and artistic work. So any work related to literacy or any work, any artistic work wants copyright. So basically there are two categories: industrial property and second is copyright. Now you can easily see here a diagram. Which include the definition by intellectual property right. So intellectual property right is a creation of the mind. Intellectual property right is the creation of the mind of an individual which has a commercial and moral values. Okay. And intellectual property right IPR grant exclusive right of to an author for utilizing and benefiting from their creation. And the types of IPR, intellectual property rights, are patent, most common, then copyright, then trademark. Okay. After that, design, database, and trade secret. All these are the basically intellectual property rights. These are the different types of intellectual property right. Now I think the definition of intellectual property right is quite clear to all of you, and the types of also now you can see the different types of intellectual property rights here. These are, I will repeat it again: patent, copyright, trademark, design, database, and any trade secret is also a intellectual property right. Now let us talk about first of all copyright. What is a copyright? Basically, a copyright protects someone who creates an original work. An original work can be a book, it may be a play, it may be a website. So work regarding to that is need a copyright. And the goal of the copyright is to prevent the unauthorized copying of your work. So that is the main objective of the copyright, to prevent unauthorized access or unauthorized copying of your work. Look at the point: prevent unauthorized copying of your work. Okay. And basically copyright related to a book, a play, or it may be a website. So basically we can say that copyright protect literacy, dramatic, you can see the diagram, any musical composition is also wants copyright, artistic work, any painting, any architectural work. Okay, so copyright basically protect literacy, dramatic, musical, artistic, architectural work. I think the definition of the copyright is quite clear to all of you, and what type of work are protect by copyright you can easily understand by this diagram. This is a book. So copyright is related to literacy, dramatic, any drama, any serial, any movie, then musical composition, देन आर्टिस्टिक वर्क एनी पेंटिंग एंड एनी आर्किटेक्चरल वर्क रिक्वायर्ड कॉपीराइट. नाउ आई थिंक इट इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. लेट अस सी द डेफिनेशन अगेन. सो बेसिकली कॉपीराइट प्रोटेक्ट समवन हु क्रिएट्स एन ऑरिजिनल वर्क एंड ऑरिजिनल वर्क मे बी रिगार्डिंग टू एनी लिटरेसी. इट मे बी अ बुक, इट मे बी एनी सीरियल, एनी ड्रामा, एनी मूवी, एनी म्यूजिकल कंपोजिशन, एनी पेंटिंग और एनी आर्किटेक्चरल वर्क. दीज आर प्रोटेक्टेड बाय अ कॉपीराइट. सो द गोल ऑफ द कॉपीराइट इज टू प्रिवेंट अनऑथराइज्ड कॉपिंग ऑफ योर वर्क. दैट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. द गोल ऑफ द कॉपीराइट इज टू प्रिवेंट अनऑथराइज्ड कॉपिंग ऑफ योर वर्क. सेकेंड इज लाइसेंसिंग. सो वैन ए कॉपी राइट ऑनर गिव्स परमिशन टू अ पर्टिकुलर पार्टी टू यूज द कॉपी राइटेड वर्क फॉर अ स्पेसिफिक रीजन, दैट इज कॉल्ड द लाइसेंसिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन दिस डायग्राम यू कैन ईजली सी हियर दैट दिस गर्ल बेसिकली प्ले एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट एंड ही एंड शी सेज दैट यू कैन यूज माई सॉन्ग कॉल्ड ओ ओ ये ये, दैट इज अ सॉन्ग एंड दैट इज कॉपी राइटेड. सो बेसिकली ही प्रोवाइड ए लाइसेंस टू दिस बॉय that he can song, he can basically sing a song related, sing a song that is basically that girl basically have a copyright of that song. Okay, now I think it is clear to all of you. That is called the licensing. Look at the diagram, it will give you a clear idea what is copyright and what is the concept of licensing. So the when a copyright owner gives permission to a particular party to use the copyrighted work for a specific reason, that is called the licensing. So again, we can say that copyright allows authors, musicians, artists, etc. to make money of their labor by providing licensing, and it prevents others from taking their work for free. It also prevents people from altering the work without permission. That is the most important point, and that is the benefit of using copyright. It also prevents people from altering the work without permission. So no one can alter anybody's work who have a copyright for its work without the permission. Okay, that is the main advantage of the copyright. And basically copyright uses by authors, musicians and different artists, and they basically make money for their labor, and no one can use their work for free. So that is the main objective of the copyright. Now I think concept of the copyright is quite clear to all of you. Now let us take another point, that is patent. So what is a patent? Patent is an exclusive right granted by the authority to the applicant of an invention for a limited period of time. That is the most important point, limited period of time. In lieu of full disclosure of his inventions. So first of all, it is an exclusive right. Okay. And patent is basically provided for a limited period of time only for a particular invention. Okay. So we can see that a patent is a property right granted to the invention by the patent office, first of all. Okay, now I think it is clear visible to all of you. So a patent is a property right granted to the inventor by the patent office, first thing. And second important thing is that it is a right to exclude other from making, using, offering for sale or selling or importing invention into the jurisdiction. And as far as the time is concerned, time is about 17 to 20 years. Because in the previous slide, I just focus on the point, limited period of time. You can easily see that. Patent is for limited period of time. And as far as time is concerned, this is about 17 to 20 years. And the scope of the patent is the jurisdiction and the subject to the right of other patent and agreement. And the last important thing, once issued, patentee must enforce the right. So, two or more important things are there. First of all, a patent is related to an invention, first thing. Second, it is provided by patent office. Third important thing, it is an exclusive right provided for about 17 to 20 years. Okay, so these are the points regarding to patent. I think the concept of patent is quite clear to all of you. Now let us take another point, trademark. So what is a trademark? I think all of you are familiar of this concept, trademark. Because in our general life, we can see it for different companies' production, different related to different companies' products. For example, a bottle of Coca-Cola is there, in which there is a symbol related to a trademark, which represents a trademark for that. Okay, another symbol related to Nike, which is a trademark for the Nike. So now, what is trademark? Basically, trademark is a distinctive sign. Okay, it is a distinctive sign which identifies the goods and services of one company from those of another. First thing. Second thing is that a trademark helps consumers to identify and choose between product services based on their reputation and quality. So that is the main objective of the trademark. So first of all, trademark is a distinctive sign. Look at the word distinctive sign. And why it is used? Because it identifies the goods and services of one company from those of another. Because different companies basically launch product in same fields. For example, there are different companies which produce basically or cold drinks. Coca-Cola is one of them, Pepsi is another. So basically, a trademark is a distinctive sign which identifies the goods and services of the company from those of the another. So that is the slide regarding to the trademark. I hope it is clear to all of you. Let us take another slide. Now, second question, what is a trademark for? What is a trademark for? So, a trademark identifies a company to the customer. First thing, trademark identifies a company to the customer. Second point, customers know that the trademark. And third, they have learned to trust that company makes good products. Okay, so these are the three points regarding to the trademarks. What is a trademark for? First one is, a trademark identifies a company to the customer. Second, customer know that trademark. And third thing is that they have learned to trust that company makes good products. Now, one of the most important question, what is the difference between a patent and a trademark and a copyright? So difference between copyright, patent and trademark, because all of them belongs to the intellectual property right. So these are the difference given among them. First point is regarding to copyright, you can easily see on the screen. Second related to patent, and third is related to trademark. First of all, when we talk about the copyright basically protect expression, not ideas. Copyright protect expressions, not ideas. But when we talk about the patent basically protect ideas that have been reduced to practice. And third point regarding to trademark is that trademark basically protect goodwill associated with marks. So what they protect is the first point. Copyright protect expression, patent protect basically ideas, and trademark protect goodwill. As far as time is concerned, the time of the copyright is basically the life of the author plus 70 years. Okay, for example, if any author write a book, then the life of its author and plus 70 years, that time period is basically he contain the copyright of that book. Patent, as I told you earlier that basically from 17 to 20 years from filing, and trademark 10 years of increments are there. After one interval of 10 years, trademark is allotted for another 10 years. So 10-year increments are there in case of trademarks. Now, as far as use is concerned, copyright fair use, patent no fair use, no research exemption, and as far as trademark is concerned, again fair use. So these are the three topics, three difference between copyright, patent and trademark. Now let us define the difference in detail. So first of all, when we talk about who it serves, so in the case of the trademark it is brands, in the case of copyright it is authors, in the case of patent it is inventors. So who it serves in the case of trademark? Brands. In the case of copyright they are authors, in the case of patent they are inventors. Most important thing, purpose. What is the purpose of the trademark? Basically, trademark distinguish. Wait a second. Trademark distinguishes products or services from competitors. That's why trademark is used. And purpose of the copyright is to protect original creative and intellectual work. And the purpose of the patent is to grant exclusive right to exploit an invention. Example of trademark are words, logos, slogans, colors. Example of copyright are music, art, photography. Example of patents are medical devices, technologies. So these are the different fields of patent. Now, most important, time limit. As I told you that time limit of the trademark is basically not defined. Basically, there is an interval increment of 10 years, indefinite. As far as copyright is concerned, life of the author plus 70 years. So it is about 70 to 170 years. And as I told you earlier, the life of the patent is between 15 to 20 years. In most common cases it is 17 to 20 years. Now that is the difference between trademark, copyright and patent. Now I think it is clear to all of you as far as difference is concerned between trademark and copyright and copyright and patent. And it may be asked in the examination because it is a very important point. Intellectual property right clearly mentioned in your syllabus. So now our topic is complete, basically related to intellectual property, right? And this is a very important topic, and it may be asked in examination. Basically, question related to patent, trademark, or a copyright, or the difference between them is also asked in examination. So prepare this question. Now our next topic is plagiarism. What is plagiarism? Let us say, basically plagiarism is using another person's ideas in your writing without giving credit to that person. Okay. So plagiarism is using another person's ideas in your writing without giving credit to that person. Or in other words, we can say that plagiarism is the copying information and not giving the author's credit for it. It means if you just copy information of someone else and not giving credit to that person, then it is called as plagiarism, and it is considered as a cyber crime. Okay, so in short, we can say that plagiarism is an act of stealing someone else's creativity, ideas, or language. And it is considered as a cheating and the corrupt act. In advanced countries with high standard of education, plagiarism is considered as an academic crime. But it often goes unnoticed in some countries, including Cambodia. So in some countries it is considered as a crime, but in some countries, in advanced countries, it is considered as a crime, but some countries it is not considered as a cyber crime. So basically, plagiarism is nothing but only the stealing someone's idea without giving the credit to their work is called the plagiarism, and it is related to the creativity, ideas, or language, means intellectual work. Now there are two types of plagiarism: deliberate plagiarism and accidental plagiarism. So as the word says that deliberate plagiarism, it means efforts are deliberately made. So that's why they are called the deliberate plagiarism. Okay, wait a minute. Now I think it is clear to all of you. So deliberate plagiarism include rewriting from books or articles, while accidental plagiarism, not knowing when and how to cite. Deliberate plagiarism including copying and pasting from web pages and online sources to create a patchwork writing, while accidental plagiarism include accidental plagiarism not knowing how to paraphrase or summarize. Okay, actually accidental plagiarism not knowing what common knowledge is. And last point regarding to deliberate plagiarism is it include buying, downloading, or borrowing a paper. While accidental plagiarism include recycling an old paper. Okay. Our next topic is crowdsourcing. And what is crowdsourcing? Crowdsourcing is the act of collecting services, ideas, or content through the contribution of a large group of people. That's why it is called the crowdsourcing. And crowdsourcing involves obtaining work, information, or opinions from a large group of people who submit their data via the internet, social media, and smartphone apps. And people involved in crowdsourcing sometimes work as a paid freelancers, while others perform small tasks on a voluntary basis. For example, traffic apps encourage drivers to report accidents एंड अदर रोडवेज एक्सीडेंट्स टू प्रोवाइड रियल टाइम अपडेटेड इंफॉर्मेशन टू एप्स यूजर. सो इन शॉर्ट वी कैन से दैट क्राउड सोर्सिंग इज द एक्ट ऑफ कलेक्टिंग सर्विसेज आइडियाज और कंटेंट थ्रू द कंट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ लार्ज ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड द क्राउड सोर्सिंग. ओके एंड क्राउड सोर्सिंग बेसिकली वर्क एज पेड फ्रीलांसर्स एंड व्हाइल अदर्स परफॉर्म स्मॉल टास्क ऑन ए वॉलंटरी बेसिस. सो टू डिफरेंट वेज ऑफ क्राउड सोर्सिंग आर देयर. और नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज स्मार्ट मूव्स. तो व्हाट इज स्मार्ट मूव? बेसिकली स्मार्ट मूव इज द मोस्ट कॉमन वर्ड यूज्ड इन आवर टुडेज लाइफ. स्मार्ट मूव इज एन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल हु हैव गैदर्ड थ्रू द यूज ऑफ सोशल मीडिया टू प्रोटेस्ट और लॉबी फॉर ए पब्लिसाइज्ड सोशल और पॉलिटिकल कॉजेस. ओके एंड यूजिंग सोशल मीडिया एनीवन कैन ऑर्गेनाइज अ स्मार्ट मूव बाय deciding about the goal, deciding about the event, event size, place, date and time, and forming a short digital message informing people about it, and finally sending this message through the use of social media to the target group of people, So smart moves basically is a combination of two words, smart move. MOFs is smart because they use social media sites basically, or they are the organized people. So smart move is an organized group of people. First of all, it is an organized group of people and they have gathered through the use of social media. So there is a very importance of social media. When we talk about the smart moves, so gathering of the different peoples using a social media and they are the organized is called the smart moves. In short, we can say that. And for what purpose they are gathered? They gathered for protest or lobby for a publicized social or political causes. And second important thing, there are some few points regarding to smart moves. Using social media, anyone can organize a social smart moves. First of all, by deciding the goal, that is the first point. Second point, deciding about the event, event size, place, date and time. Third, forming a short digital message informing people about it. And four, sending this message through the use of social media to the target group of people. Okay. Next point is net neutrality. So what is net neutrality? Net neutrality basically refers to a principle implemented so that an ISP, means internet service provider, such as Jio, Vodafone or Airtel, enables access to all sites, their content and applications regardless of the source without favoring or blocking particular content, product or website. That is the most important point, last line, without favoring. And with net neutrality, basically an internet service provider ISP must ensure three points. First point is it provides access to all sites in the same way. First point, it loads the content and applications of sites and web applications at the same speed. And third, all content get loaded under the same condition without blocking or giving preferences to any content. So that is the net neutrality. So three points are there. Basically, all sides have same access. Second thing, as far as loads the content and application of the sites is concerned, they have same speed. And third thing is, all content get loaded under the same conditions. That is called the net neutrality, and it is provided by ISP. It means internet service provider. Internet service provider who provide you service of the internet. Thanks for watching this video.